Hi lads, welcome to Warcraft 3. This is a game I'm gonna be honest with you, I'm not too familiar with. Last time I played it is in 2002. I did finish a single player campaign on hard, and 15 years ago. I didn't like the custom mapping stuff for it, so I kinda skipped on it and then Frozen Throne. I mean, honestly, it wasn't that bad, but for some reason I kind of just expected StarCraft. And like, I had like a little, I have a lot of history around StarCraft and I expected a lot of the stuff around that, but that kind of the engine limitations around they basically made a game with few units because it was the first kind of 3D RTS game that Blizzard made, and not that ever existed, it's the first one that Blizzard made. So they kind of designed the entire game around that, and I wasn't, like, a huge fan of it. And then I tried, like, Dota at some point when Dota was coming out. Did not fucking understand that, at all. And so I just basically hated Warcraft 3, like, completely. But now things are a bit different, because now, like, I played the Dota 2, and that actually, you know, I got a little bit more into that one, because that one actually has, like, I could kind of grasp what was going on, and I grasped the strategy of it. But this isn't like a Dota fucking thing. This is all about Warcraft 3 and single player. I don't think I ever hated the single player campaign, but every time I thought of Warcraft 3, I just basically thought of like the custom maps for this game and stuff. I mean, there were some cool maps for this game. And honestly, as I said, I look back and I'm like, you know, I was kind of fucking retarded in that way. So this is me coming back into it because I just did Warcraft 2. And everyone was really excited for Warcraft 3, so I'm like, yeah, sure, you know what, we'll do it. And so now I have kind of a fresh perspective on it, you know, it's gonna be like, we could just forget about everything I've said about the game. Well, I've never really said anything about it, but we could forget everything, like my past about it, like the fact that I didn't really do it. We're giving it a fresh new kind of a perspective and stuff like that. I've never really... I might as well have never played it before. As I said, if I played it in 2002, I kind of recollect the storyline, some of the mechanics and stuff like that. So, a couple of things. So first off, playing the campaign completely on hard, probably not a big deal for me, because I played StarCraft 2 on brutal. I play a lot of RTS games on hard difficulties. But the fact that it is, I will say, semi-blind, I don't remember what's going on. I will not be 100%, like, doing everything the first time kind of a thing, probably. Who knows? I don't know. I'm just warning you that I might be a shit stain a few times. As for, apparently, there's like a lot of like hidden items and crap in the game and secret levels and all kinds of shit like that. And so I was warned before starting this. Some people were like, you know, people are really gonna fucking hate if you're missing stuff. So on my second monitor, I actually have... it doesn't tell me spoilers about the game, but it does tell me where secrets are. Or, like, weird item droppables and stuff, so I will be reading off of that and just kind of picking it up and stuff like that. I mean, it's like, I don't really care about spoilers or something, and... I mean, this way I kind of get everything, so I'm admitting to that fact. I do have on my second monitor. It doesn't tell me how to win the game, but it does tell me where, like... For example, one of them is defensive strong something. Graveyard ghost. Any unit you kill that is not a footman has a corresponding ghost in the graveyard. It's an Easter egg, apparently. But they also have, like, a bunch of stuff where, like, it drops, like, an important item and stuff. But apparently I'm supposed to just kill everything and whatever, so... But if this really bothers you, I'm just telling you now, so, like, if you don't fucking get, like, halfway through, then hate me for whatever reason. Like, I've warned you about everything. As I said, it's... but, you know, on the other hand, you get kind of a perspective of someone who's maybe not... as familiar with the game. And as I said, Frozen Throne, completely blind. Never touched it. As I said, just for the reason of, I kept thinking of Warcraft 3, and I just kept thinking, like, oh, the mapping's not like StarCraft. I find it funny, because a lot of people complain about StarCraft 2's mapping, because it's not like Warcraft 3's. So it just, I think it came up to personal preference, and it also came up to expectations, and it just didn't... I had, for every, I bought it when it came out. Like, I had the fucking, like, orc box. Probably downstairs somewhere, but... you know, it was coming out, and I'm like, I had been playing StarCraft 1 for, like, fucking, like, 6 years or something, or 5 years, or whatever the fuck. And, like, every minute I was like, oh my god, I can't wait until a new Blizzard RTS comes out. I'll have the same amount of fun I did with the mapping community in that one, and the customs are so great, and kind of really didn't meet the expectations, as I said. I mean, the same goes for StarCraft 2 with me right now. I even made maps for StarCraft 2, and I didn't like the customs for that at all. But, you know, it's just, I call it nostalgia or some other dumb reason. It probably is, all that kind of stuff, so... as I said, that's pretty much it for me with that, so let's get it, dive into single player. Campaign. As I said, I haven't really done anything with the single player. So I'm playing on, hard difficulty, so that should be good. But apparently we have some, cutscenes before that. So let's, have a look at them.
Never paid any heed to the ancient prophecies. Like fools, we clung to the old hatreds. And fought as we had for generations. We stand now upon the brink of destruction, for the reign of chaos has come at last.
Oh boy, do you feel the hype? I feel the hype. Yeah, it's Thrall's vision.
The sands of time have run out, son of Durotan. Cries of war echo upon the winds. The remnants of the past scar the land. Which is besieged once again by conflict. Heroes arise to challenge fate and lead their brethren to battle. as mortal armies rush blindly towards their doom. The burning shadow comes to consume us all. Rally the Horde and lead your people to their destinies. Seek me out.
Alright, so for people who don't know, that character you saw waking up at the end is Thrall. He was cancelled. Well, he was from the cancelled game Warcraft Adventures. The game was pretty bad. It's a joke, but you know. But they kind of reused the same character in this one, where he's like half human, half orc. I don't know too much about the lore. If I'm wrong about anything, you can correct me, I don't give a fuck, whatever. Let's do chapter one of the tutorial.
That.
It was not a nightmare, young war chief, but a vision. Follow me, and I will reveal what your future holds.
I don't know what this is all about, but I'll play along.
Alright.
The spirits are restless.
Let's destroy stuff.
For honor.
Oh, let's go find secrets.
Dabu.
Excellent. You seem eager to be on your way. However, you must first learn how to give orders to Thrall. Try ordering Thrall to move down the path towards the nearby banner. To do this, click the move button in the bottom right corner of your screen and then click on the banner.
Dabu.
Should I see this thing over here? Oh, shit. Oh, no such thing. I also raise the speed of the mouse scroll. I'm actually wondering if, I use always show hotbars. I don't have custom shortcuts on my keyboard. Probably would be a good idea, because you see these inventory keys? I don't have a numpad on my keyboard, so I actually have to click them manually. I'm not sure how much of a problem that's going to be, but I'll kind of play it by ear. I'll see. I'm a micromanaging king, so we'll see. We got like quests and some other shit here and whatever else. No, we're going up here actually. Oh dude, there's a fucking deer here. Fuck that thing. No bonuses here. We found the secret deer, guys. First secret down. I don't think there's any secrets in the tutorial, by the way, so.
Yes.
Whatever.
Skillfully done. However, the orc encampment is still far off. In order to reach the next banner, scroll the screen to the north by moving your mouse to the top edge of the screen. Very good. The path to the next banner leads through a black area. This black area represents terrain that has not been discovered yet.
Dabu.
For honor.
Notice how the black area shrinks as Thrall moves through it. This reflects areas you have explored.
There's some story here, and also, I guess if you don't understand, fucking this shit, whatever.
Select Thrall and order him to move to the banner in the middle of the encampment.
For honor.
Oh god, I missed three secrets already.
I am the War Chief. Lotar, my warriors.
We are yours to command, War Chief.
Now that your troops are all selected, order them to move to the next banner.
Yes.
Oh, there's boars to kill. Or pigs, sorry.
For Doomhammer!
Alright. No pig will be left alive here. Alright, they didn't give me any bonus items.
I am the War Chief.
I don't even know why I'm, like, exploring every little nook and cranny. Oh shit, there's one lived. No secrets. As I said, my little cheat sheet didn't have anything for this anyways.
Prepare yourselves. I sense a knoll ahead.
To to order Thrall's forces to defeat this foul creature, select all of your troops, click on the attack button, and then click on the knoll.
This was only a scout, but the knoll's camp lies just ahead.
Order your troops to perform an aggressive attack move into the enemy encampment. To do this, select all of your troops, click the attack button, and then left-click on the ground in the middle of the knoll camp.
So I saw something about, alt key does formation movement toggle. I don't know what the fuck that even does.
Master, Loktar, the spirits are resting.
I'll just focus them all down. I know that was a big thing in this game, is to like focus things down.
Look, Naru!
Oh dude, you got a level. What do I want Thrall to have?
Your time!
Good job. Notice that Thrall gained a level from the experience. Whenever you click on the Hero Abilities button, the bottom right corner of your screen changes to show what abilities can be learned. To spend Thrall's hero point and learn Chain Lightning.
Okay, I kind of skipped the ballot, but I don't think any of you really care.
Yes.
Alright, we need to kill all the buildings, because there could be things in there. You never know. This also takes an enormous amount of time. Alright, there's no treasure there. So we got Chain Lightning. See? Oh, thank goodness, we have, like, actually good hotkeys.
Yes.
Spoiled by a fucking...
War Chief, we've discovered a group of Murloc raiders in the nearby river.
The Murlocs would make excellent targets for your new Chain Lightning spell. To have Thrall use his new ability, click on the Chain Lightning button and then left-click on one of the Murlocs. Some monsters drop treasure when they are defeated. This particular treasure chest contained a useful potion of mana. Notice that the potion now occupies one of Thrall's inventory slots near the bottom middle of your screen. Potions of mana can be used to replenish a hero's mana, the magic energies that allow the casting of spells such as Chain Lightning.
Double.
Well, we learned something good today. Just wondering if there's something else over here somewhere.
For honor. Yes.
We don't need to Chain Lightning this. There's like only two of them.
Let's get on.
Pretty good shit. We can like zoom in and zoom out and shit.
For honor. Dabu.
The wolf howl signifies that night has begun.
Be wary, my warriors. Don't let nightfall dull your senses. For honor.
Oh, they can't see Dabu. Us far, really?
For honor. Yes.
Man, I'm so good at the tutorial.
For honor. Dabu.
Oh. Oh,
the spirits.
Potion of healing.
Yes.
So yeah, I actually have to left click that shit. Alright, we can't see anything here.
Yes.
Yeah, so I have to actually left click everything, so good times.
Dabu. An ogre. We'd have a fierce battle on our hands if the beast weren't sleeping.
Yeah, fuck that thing. Fierce battle. No, it's pretty fierce. Let me tell you that.
The spirits are blessed.
And we don't get anything for that?
For honor.
I'm very sad.
For honor. Dabu. Dabu.
As I said, I don't remember any of this, so I guess the tutorial is also good for kind of story purposes. We get a bit of an introduction.
Dabu.
And I kind of get used to the controlling of this game, you know. Kind of looking Dabu. Through everything and seeing if there's anything here.
Watch yourselves, my brethren. Those creatures do not sleep at night. I am.
This doesn't feel very hard. What, really?
Lokriga, no
god. There was nothing here. Oh no, they're right here.
Doom hammer.
There we go. I do not sleep at night.
Let's get on.
Ring of protection.
Dabu. Master.
Fuck,
the
really?
Spirits are resting.
Excellent. Thrall has found a magic ring. Rings are very useful because they provide a constant passive benefit as long as they are carried.
Yes.
What are they? Oh,
none
there's another one here.
Survive. I am the Warcraft.
So it's just used on myself, I guess, for the potion.
Dabu.
And nothing
for
here.
Honor.
All right, nothing but disappointment.
Yes. Dabu.
That's okay. We got a ring of protection.
For
That's
honor.
My armor at 4+1.
The spirits are restless.
It'll make all the difference.
Yes. Dabu. For honor. Yes.
Oh, this is a...
For honor.
Simple first mission.
Yes.
Oh, hey, no.
Forest trolls. I still can't believe they were ever a part of the Horde.
That's racist. See, the difficulty of a particular monster move your cursor over it.
Let's get on.
See how difficult they are. Actually, I should probably just fucking chain lightning them.
For Doom Hammer!
Yes? Smobu! Zugzug! Lokrika, no doubt.
There's like my sick micro.
What you want?
The spirits are restless. I am the Warchief.
Alright, well, let's teach him a lesson.
Let's get on.
So obviously, no, we don't get that. Oh, dude, manual of health.
Very good. That treasure chest held a magic tome that can be used to give Thrall a permanent benefit.
Let's get on.
Ah, so they disappear. Yes. Oh, good shit.
Yes.
Well, I guess we got nothing else out of that. Let's see. Yes. So if I, like, move them around, they have, like, this formation thing, which is really weird.
For honor.
But if I press Alt,
Dabu.
Then they just kind of move however they like. Or no, they don't.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, they do. So what does that even do? Nation enable formation movement toggle.
Dabu.
I'm actually not quite sure how that works. Yeah, then they just do it no matter what. I don't know if that's like really a good thing or whatever, but whatever. It's actually kind of annoying how they go into formation. Dabu. I wish it did death ball. I love fucking death balls. These kinds Dabu. Of games.
Yes.
That's life. Sometimes you don't get to have a death ball.
Yes.
What the fuck? Oh, he's here. Oh, I missed something over here, probably. Oh no.
Restless. Dabu. For honor.
Greetings, son of Duritan. I knew you'd find your way.
It was you I saw in the vision. Who are you? How do you know me?
I know many things, young warchief, about you and your people. My identity at this time is unimportant. What is important is that you rally your people and leave these shores immediately.
Leave? What's this all about, human?
Human? I left my humanity behind long ago. I am something different now. Know that I have seen the future and beheld the great burning shadow that is coming to consume this world. You sense it as well, don't you?
The demons are returning.
Yes, and only by leading your people across the sea to the distant lands of Kalimdor will you have a chance to stand against them.
But how could we...
I will answer all of your questions in time, young warchief. For now, rally your warriors and prepare to leave this land. We will speak again.
None of this makes sense. But the spirits tell me that I should trust him.
I love the lack of lip syncing. They're like chewing the air. Oh, we did so good.